My first bug bounty experience was an absolute disaster. I wasted hours chasing ghosts, got lost in recon hell, almost reported something out of scope, and thought running random scanners would make me rich. In this video, I'm going to show you the unfiltered reality of what it's like starting bug bounties, all the traps you'll fall into, and the mindset shifts that take you from clueless beginner to someone who can actually make money breaking into systems. I remember my first bug bounty like it was yesterday. I was hyped, thinking I'd immediately find a critical RCE and flex it online, but reality hit me like a misconfigured firewall. First lesson, preparation matters way more than raw energy. You can't just dive in thinking, I'll figure it out on the spot. I spent hours staring at the same login page, refreshing like it owed me money, before realizing I hadn't even properly scoped the target. Always check the program rules. Know exactly what's in scope, what's out of scope, and most importantly, what will get you banned instantly. There's nothing worse than spending hours finding a bug only to realize it's on a forbidden endpoint. Next, tools are great, but they won't replace understanding. I tried running random automated scanners, expecting magic, and got nothing but false positives and headaches. The real insight came when I started thinking like a user and a developer. Ask yourself, if I were this application, where would I screw up? That mindset alone will save you days of useless clicks and scans. Then comes recon. Most beginners underestimate this part. I spent a whole day ignoring directories, forgotten subdomains, and old parameters because I was too excited about flashy payloads. The truth is, 90% of low-hanging vulnerabilities come from observing patterns, reading responses carefully, and understanding application logic. Take notes obsessively. Every endpoint, every header, every cookie could be a breadcrumb. I used to overlook this thinking I'd remember everything, but that's a trap. Organized recon and thorough documentation are what separate "I might find something" from "I just made my first report." Now let's talk mindset. Frustration hit hard in bug bounty. I spent hours trying the same injection over and over before realizing the application was using an encoding I didn't account for. You will feel dumb, and that's normal. Embrace it. Every failed payload teaches you something. Keep a mental log of your failures. Over time, patterns emerge, and what seemed impossible becomes obvious. Don't skip the community either. I tried solo at first, but once I joined forums, Discord groups, and bug bounty chats, my speed and understanding skyrocketed. Seeing what others find, the mistakes they make, the clever tricks they use, it's like a cheat code for learning without losing your own time to trial and error. Another subtle trap is scope creep in your own workflow. I would get lost testing edge cases that weren't critical, chasing fancy bugs while ignoring what actually matters to the program. Remember, not every vulnerability is a goldmine. Prioritize impact, not novelty. Once you start reporting, clarity matters as much as the bug itself. A messy, half-explained report is useless no matter how severe the issue is. Screenshots, step-by-step reproduction, and concise explanations are your friends. Think like someone who has to verify your work under time pressure. They shouldn't need a decoder ring to understand what you found. Then there's the adrenaline factor. When you finally see the bug-confirmed email, it feels like winning a lottery, but don't let it make you careless. Each program has rules, each bounty has limits, and overconfidence will get you flagged fast. Finally, always reflect. After each submission, review what worked, what failed, and what could be faster next time. Self-analysis turns chaotic attempts into systematic growth. Looking back, my first experience was messy, frustrating, and borderline embarrassing. But every mistake became a lesson. When I first started bug bounty, my biggest struggle wasn't payloads or fancy exploits. It was complete chaos. Notes scattered everywhere, recon half-finished, reports that looked like they were written by a sleep-deprived raccoon. I wasted so much time, not because I was dumb, but because I had no system. And if you're feeling that too, I got you. I put together a free resource, a complete bug bounty checklist and recon template that shows you exactly how to structure your workflow. It breaks down what to scan, in what order, how to document findings, and how to turn chaos into an actual strategy. It's pinned in the comments below, totally free, and it's everything I wish I had when I was starting out. Now, that alone is enough to get you moving, but here's the thing. The premium tool inside Cyberflow's Academy takes that same workflow and automates the pain out of it. Instead of you juggling recon, notes, and report drafts, the tool does it for you. It maps your recon automatically, organizes endpoints, flags interesting parameters, and even helps you draft clean reports so your submissions don't get ignored. Basically, the free version is manual mode, it works, the Academy version is turbo mode. Same principles, but way faster and way less stressful. And Cyberflow's Academy isn't just about tools. Look, I know you can learn hacking online for free. That's how I did it. I crawled through scattered write-ups, sketchy forums, and hundreds of tutorials until it finally clicked. You can absolutely do the same. But if you want a shortcut, an organized, personalized path that actually gets you from zero to pro without wasting years, that's what we built the Academy for. You'll get every tool you'll ever need, and I don't just teach theory, I show you every single way I personally make money from hacking, still working today. Bug bounties, freelancing gigs, building pen testing services, and even YouTube. And people are already winning with it. One guy pulled his first $1,000 bounty within a month, another scored a long-term freelance contract, and I've even seen people spin up YouTube channels around hacking that are actually growing. It's $30 a month, but for those of you who stuck around to the end, you can get 50% off with the code CYBER50. That's $15 to unlock everything. Join if you want the shortcut. Don't if you're happy grinding it out. Either way, keep hacking, stay secure, and have a wonderful day.